So in today's video, I want to answer a question which we get asked as EV owners a lot, which is, what if I wake up one day and I want to drive to Scotland? So here we are.
So it's a Monday and we've been having a chat tonight and we were looking for a last minute holiday to go on, going snowboarding. But everything's really expensive at the moment. So what we've decided and why I'm recording this video is that on Saturday, we're going to get up and drive to Scotland. We're obviously going to do it in our EV, our Tesla Model 3. And I thought, well, this might be a good opportunity to record a video because we get asked this question a load, which is, what if I want to drive to Scotland? And I'm always like, well, that doesn't happen, does it? But actually, we've decided to do it. So I thought, well, we'll sort of see how we get on the trip, see what Scotland's like for charging as well, because it's quite remote up there. We're going to be going into sort of a Ben Nevis area, I think, looking at where the ski resorts and snowboard resorts are, and let you know how we get on.
So firstly, the idea was to get to Scotland as soon as possible, but we decided to make an overnight stay before our final destination for the week. This wasn't really because of anything to do with EV charging, but more because we had a young dog with us and we weren't sure how he was going to be doing long journeys in the car. He's probably only been in the car for about 2 hours at most. So we thought it'd be a good idea to have an overnight stay because then it was quite a windy journey round to our final destination, which was up towards the Nevis Resorts area, which is by Ben Nevis. So we drove all the way up past Manchester, made a couple of stops on the way, which I'll go into some detail. Obviously did our charging stops where we needed to, grabbed a cup of coffee, went for a wee, took the dog for a quick walk, made sure he went to the toilet, and then we were on our way again. Now, we actually made more stops and did more charging than we needed to. And I can't stress this enough because people think that when you're doing a journey in an EV, it will hold you up. But we actually stopped more than we needed to because we wanted to stop, stretch our legs, get some fresh air, get a drink, go to the loo, and then carry on. So having an EV did not in any way restrict our journey. Again, I want to really emphasise this because this is a point that people get stuck on all the time. And I don't think they really think about how many stops they take on the way on a long journey for a comfort break. And you should do it because driving is tiring and driving tired can be really dangerous. So you do need to make those stops, get some fresh air, have a breather before you carry on your long journey. Now, the only preparation that we really did for the journey in terms of having an EV was producer Claire applied for a ChargePlace Scotland card and set up our account with these. Now, this seems to be a national charging system that's in place. They have tons of chargers all over Scotland and they're super cheap. So we got the card. It came in the post literally the day before we travelled. But if you don't have that much time and you set off without having your ChargePlace Scotland card, you can just use the app as well. But the card is really useful if you are planning a trip because sometimes it was difficult to get a phone signal in some of the more remote locations where the card would work. Obviously, we set off with a fully charged vehicle and the first stop we made was at Abington Services, which is actually quite far north. We did have a couple of stops in between that, like I say, for a coffee and to stretch our legs. But the first charging stop was Abington. We filled up the car as much as possible and then pushed on to Loch Lomond, where we stayed for the night in a town called Bollock. We stayed at Loch Lomond. They do have EV chargers at our accommodation, and that seems to be really common around Scotland. The other noticeable thing was that as we entered Scotland, there was a ton more of PV and wind turbines. So a lot of renewable energy. And I believe this is down to the fact that there are extra grants, extra incentives and extra subsidisation from the government to move Scotland to renewable electricity. But I just thought it was really interesting how this was physically notable as you cross the border. The next day we took the scenic route up from the tip of Loch Lomond, went to see a few sites along the way, including Inveraray Jail, Kilmartin, and the route itself along the A83 was absolutely beautiful. I really can't put into words how stunningly beautiful and dramatic the landscape is. Scotland has been on our wish list for a long time, and I'm really glad we had the opportunity to go there. And then over that next day, we wound our way up to a small place that had got some lodges not far from Glencoe and Fort William. Now, at this accommodation, although there were EV chargers, they weren't actually working. We couldn't actually get them to work. I think it was a connectivity issue. There was an EV charger literally 5 minutes walk at another hotel just down the road, but we decided not to use that because we'd left enough in the battery just in case. And we knew there'd be EV chargers everywhere we were planning to go while we were in Scotland. So we thought, yep, we'll leave it. We've got a better opportunity to charge the next day. We also stopped in a dog-friendly pub for a quick meal in the town of Oban. Again, really beautiful, really nice pub, and there was an EV charger there, so we thought while we park there, we may as well plug into the 22 kilowatt charger and get as much charge as possible. So I think, again, when you're stopping, always try and find a car park with an EV charger. If it works, plug in, get some charge, great. Super cheap. If you can use the 22 kilowatt or 7 kilowatt chargers instead of the rapid chargers, they're normally cheaper as well. So we were only paying 20 pence per kilowatt hour for the 22 kilowatt and 7 kilowatt chargers. And we were only paying 30 pence per kilowatt hour for the fast DC 50 kilowatt and 100 kilowatt chargers. So over the next few days, we took the opportunity to see as many sites as possible, such as the Glenfinnan Viaduct, which you saw at the start of the video in the intro. We went to Nevis, went to a waterfall near Glencoe. So, can you spot our Tesla? There it is. Right in the middle of the shot there. That was f***ing steep. Fort William itself is a nice little town. It has some Tesla superchargers, which was great. But again, when we were staying longer, we tried to use the ChargePlace Scotland chargers just because there was so much better value for money. Nevis Resorts itself had chargers. We did have a few issues in getting that working. I don't have footage of that because I was on the phone to ChargePlace Scotland. However, with a little bit of persistence, they helped us out, got us up and running, and we charged there all day while we did a hike around the base of the Nevis Resort area. And it was absolutely beautiful. So, when somebody asks me next time, what if I want to drive to Scotland? My advice would be, just do it. Scotland has great charging infrastructure. There's enough charging infrastructure around the UK to get you there. And if you're planning a holiday and you're worried about range anxiety and not being able to get there, just plan your journey carefully. We didn't plan our journey. We just set out and checked out the charge points on the way there. Honestly, it wasn't too bad. I know our car has got quite a big range, the Tesla Model 3 long range. However, even with a car with smaller range, I'm sure you'd be fine, as long as you planned your journey.
And so you don't have to miss out on beautiful sights like this just because you own an electric car.
The journey back was also no problem. We'd made a stop off somewhere around Carlisle. That didn't have EV charging, but again, it just wasn't an issue. We stopped off on the motorway services. Now, Now, I don't want to dwell on costs too much, as these are quite volatile. Electricity prices are changing. Oil prices are quite volatile. But I thought it'd be a good idea to just document how much it cost us and how much it would have cost us in our previous car, which was a Ford Focus, if we'd done the same journey. So I'm flashing these costs up off the spreadsheet right now. Now, as I'm sure you can see, again, the EV wins out hands down every time. So, I hope the video was useful. Hope it was interesting. I hope it inspires you, if you've got an EV, to go to Scotland, or it inspires you to get an EV, even if you do journeys regularly to places like Scotland, Cornwall, lots of other remote places. Don't let having an EV slow you down and stop you seeing what you want to see around the world. And if anything, the reduced cost of travel means that you can get around a little bit more and you can feel better about the fact that your carbon emissions are reduced compared to if you were in a petrol or diesel vehicle. So make sure you give us a cheeky thumbs up on that like button, subscribe, hit the bell icon for notifications of our future videos. Make sure you check out our other social media. If you want to see more of Noodle, check out his Instagram @NoodleMiniSausage. And in the meantime, thanks very much for watching.